Shalom, Messiah, Christ bless you all. This is Officer Emmanuel with IUIC Dallas. So today, in the classroom, we'll be diving into OnlyFans. OnlyFans, all right? OnlyFans has become very popular globally today, especially in the Western world, all right? OnlyFans is a rippling whirlstorm, all right? It's become a pandemic, plague, or disease amongst everyone, all right? Amongst every nation. But we care about our nation, the 12 tribe of Israel, all right? We cannot do what other nations are doing, all right? So let's start with the scripture, 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 16.
The book of 2 Timothy chapter 3 and verse 16. All scripture is given by inspiration of God and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness.
Go on.
That the man of God may be perfect, thoroughly furnished unto all good works.
All right. So that's my favorite scripture to bring up first. He said, all scripture, not only the New Testament, all right? All scripture, both the Old and the New Testament, is given by the inspiration of God and is profitable for doctrine, for correction, reproof, instruction in righteousness. All right? Instruction in righteousness. Why? Why? So that the man of God may be perfect, truly furnished unto all good works. Meaning what? When we apply the scriptures, when we take correction from the scriptures, when we also take instruction from these scriptures and learn doctrines, not your church doctrine or Islamic doctrine, but doctrine from the Bible, then we can be perfect. All right, give me that scripture, Proverbs chapter 4, about doctrine. Let's see what the scripture said about doctrine. Read.
The book of Proverbs, chapter 4 and verse 2. For I give you good doctrine.
Go on.
Forsake ye not my law.
Forsake ye not my law. So the doctrine of God is the law. We call this book today the Bible, but in the only time it's called the book of the law. All right? This book, this whole book, is where our doctrine comes from as Israelites. All right? Drop that. Give me Sirach 5 verse 15. Sirach chapter 5, verse 15.
The book of Sirach, chapter 5 and verse 15. Be not ignorant in anything, in a great matter or a small.
Whether it be great or small, be not ignorant, all right? We need to know what's going on amongst our people. All right, like I mentioned before, it's a pandemic plague amongst the nations, especially at this time. We care about our people, the 12 tribe of Israel, the so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native America, right? OnlyFans is a dangerous ground to walk on, all right? Many of our people love what they call the social media, and they allow themselves to go into some of the social media to monetize content. And in the process, they don't care about what it does to their soul or to their spirit. All they care about is money, all right? And this OnlyFans has become a fast, it's kind of like riding on a fast lane. I will put it that way. Riding on a fast lane, and you know what can happen? A fast lane accident, fast lane collision. The way that money started off fast, it can burn out quick. It can burn out real quick. All right? So that's something we need to be very careful about. All right? It's good to make your money. If you got to do 8 hours job, do it. 9 hours job, 9 to 5, do it. But let it be through a righteous means, not through OnlyFans, all right? So many of us may not know what OnlyFans is, because I've seen that literally amongst our people. They have never heard about it or seen it. You may not be doing it, but who knows? Your daughter might be doing it. Your son might be doing it, and they might be in the body or may not be in the body, all right? Let's go into that. Give me the first article we have about OnlyFans.
OnlyFans, OnlyFans is an internet content subscription service based in London, United Kingdom.
And one thing you're going to notice is many of these women of today, they will call themselves content creators. That's what they usually call themselves. I'm a content creator, what does they say? I'm a movie maker. You got to ask them, what kind of movie do you make? You see a 18-year-old, 19-year-old say, I'm a movie maker. What kind of movie do you make? And especially amongst the women, what kind of movie do you make? That's stuff that you got to ask. All right? Keep going.
The service is used primarily by sex workers who produce pornography.
Read it one more time.
The service is used primarily.
Primarily, mainly, majorly.
By sex workers who produce pornography.
Who produce pornography, all right? Pornography, a form of prostitution. That's what it is. All right, keep going.
But it also hosts the work of other content creators, such as physical fitness experts and musicians.
Nobody cares about it. OnlyFans is not known for physical fitness or for music, all right? OnlyFans have a bad connotation to it, which is pornography, sex work, prostitution. Because I know in the mind of some of our people, they want to, you know, people who actually create legal contents, you know, contents that are desirable, virtuous contents, I would say. You have Facebook, you have Instagram, you have, Twitter, TikTok. But because you want more money, because there's this propaganda out there that, oh, signing to OnlyFans, all of a sudden you're going to become a millionaire. You're going to make 6 figures in a month. You see that all over podcasts. Whether you be in, YouTube, all right, Patreon, all that. You see it all over the place, or Rumbler. They will tell you, oh, sign up for OnlyFans, you make tons of money in a month. They don't tell you what they go through to get to that level, all right? So that's what OnlyFans has become. It's become a primary site for sex workers, even celebrities, all right, celebrities. Everybody sign up to OnlyFans now as content creator. But it's primarily for what? To produce pornography, all right? It's a dangerous ground to walk on. Keep going.
Content on the platform is user-generated and monetized via monthly subscriptions, tips, and pay-per-view.
So monthly prescription, they get money from that, they get money from tips, and they get money from pay-per-view, all right? This OnlyFans is kind of like a combination of pornography and based on what we see in pornography and what they call this stuff, web. You know, girls who make themselves naked on web to show their body. All the stuff. Webcam. You know, I don't know what they call that stuff. But, yes, it's kind of like a combination of both. All right? That's what OnlyFans has become for the people today. Read.
Creators are paid 80% of these fees.
So that's another thing that draws people in. Because YouTube, you can have millions of views, but the percentage of money you get is small. So they try to draw people into OnlyFans. Oh, you're going to make lots of money through tips, pay-per-view, monthly subscription. All right? 80%, that's a lot of money. Go on.
The company launched a free safe-for-work streaming platform.
Free safe-for-work. Remember that word. Safe-for-work. Safe-for-work. We'll see how safe it is when we're done with this class. Go on.
OFTV in 2021.
Go on.
The website grew in popularity during the COVID-19 pandemic.
Because people were idle, people were at home. They're looking for means to make money. Go on.
As of May 2023, OnlyFans had more than 3 million registered creators and 220 million registered users. The company has been criticized for insufficiently preventing child sexual abuse material from circulating on the platform. Though statistical evidence on the severity of the problem is mixed, In August 2021, a campaign to investigate OnlyFans began in the United States Congress.
Mm-hmm.
And it was reported that from October 2021 onward, OnlyFans would no longer allow sexually explicit material.
Right, because originally it was not created for that. But majority of the users now use it for sex content. All right? Go on.
Due to pressure from banks that OnlyFans used for user payments,
mm-hmm.
however, this decision was reversed 6 days later due to backlash from users and creators alike.
All right, so that's what they said, all right? They reversed it after 6 days. Now, that's what they said originally. It's not for sex content. That's what they said, all right? But is that really true? We don't know. It doesn't matter. What matters is right now, OnlyFans is mainly used by pornographic creators, both amateur and professional. That's what's on the screen, all right? So let's read the scripture before we go into the first video. Give me Deuteronomy chapter 23, verse 17. Deuteronomy chapter 23, verse 17. What does the law say concerning whoredom or being a whore or a slut? Go ahead.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 23 and verse 17.
Mm-hmm.
There shall be no whore of the daughters of Israel.
Read one more time.
There shall be no whore of the daughters of Israel.
There shall be no whore, no hoe, slut, prostitute of who?
Of the daughters of Israel.
Of the daughters of Jacob. Our forefather Jacob, descendant, there shouldn't be anyone in his pedigree that's called a whore. Because Jacob was a righteous man. All right, he was a righteous man that kept the commandments of God. Now, us as his descendants, we should be like our father, all right, our father Jacob. Abstain from all these sexual explicits that we release as content, especially OnlyFans. Get away from OnlyFans, all right? Keep going.
Nor a sodomite of the sons of Israel.
We shouldn't have any gay or homosexuals and lesbians in Israel, in the pedigree, lineage, descendants of Jacob, Abraham, and Isaac. Go on.
Thou shalt not bring the hire of a whore.
That's another thing. He said, thou shalt not do what?
Bring the hire of a whore.
The hire of a whore. We just read about the subscription, the tips, all right? We read also
tip or pay-per-view.
The pay-per-view money. Don't bring that crap into the house of God. Don't use it for alms. Don't use it for nothing. You got to keep that money away. All right? Read it one more time.
Thou shalt not bring the hire of a whore.
So that's what it is, hire of a whore. Somebody pay you that money so you can do what? Show them your body or sell your picture. Like some people say they do. They just sell their naked picture or they sell picture of their foot, picture of their hand, whatever it is. Go on.
Or the price of a dog.
Price of a dog. A male prostitute. Go on.
Into the house of the Lord thy God for any vow.
For any vow. Go on.
For even both these are abomination unto the Lord thy God.
It's an abomination. It's stinky before God. All right? It's stinky before the Lord our God. That's what the scripture said. All right? Give me the next one. Leviticus 19 verse 29.
Leviticus chapter 19 and verse 29.
Uh-huh.
Do not prostitute thy daughter to cause her to be a whore.
Don't prostitute your daughter, all right? Some of us, some of our mothers in the world, you know your son, or most times it's the women, you know your daughter is involved in OnlyFans. You know she's doing something wrong because all of a sudden money is coming from everywhere. You don't question her because you prefer her bringing money to you than to find out what she's doing, all right, or what she's doing wrong in her life, because you see the money coming in. You know your daughter. There's no way a month ago she was broke. All of a sudden she's bringing in money. You prefer the money rather than question her. That's you prostituting your daughter. You're supposed to ask question. You're supposed to question your daughter. Your daughter is not your friend. It's not your comrade. It's not your peer. She is your daughter. She is your daughter. It's not your friend. She's not your friend. When you are not questioning them to set them right with the morals from the scripture, you are strengthening the hand of the evildoer. You are strengthening the hand of evil that's upon your daughter. All right? So the Lord said it's an abomination before him to do these things. All right? So let's go to the next video. Yeah, that's it. That's it right there. Play it. So before we play this video, pay very good attention. All right? Pay very good attention because we know, I've seen it. You may not have seen it, but I know. I've seen it out there, many videos on YouTube or on TikTok, wherever they are, promoting OnlyFans. Telling you things you should do to set up your page, to make more money, all that stuff. No. Avoid all appearance of evil. Abstain from all appearance of evil. Yes, they have a path for fitness, path for culinary activities. It doesn't matter. It does not matter. What matters is OnlyFans has a bad connotation to it. And that's sex industry or sex production. All right? So pay attention. Pay attention to this video. Let's see who else to tell you than the devil himself or herself. Go ahead.
Let me tell you this. The only people making that amount of money are the top 1%. Some of which are celebrities already, or influencers with a big following. But for any other normal girl that's just starting out on this website, the majority of them are making less than minimum wage. And they're making explicit content. Sometimes custom made. Not only that, but they're working the same amount of hours to try
because
and gain.
The usual ideology out there, or what you mostly see people say about OnlyFans is you're going to become all of a sudden a millionaire. Out of nowhere, you set up your page, make it look good, and then boom, you start having lots of clients or customers. That's what they are. Sex clients, sex customers, paying you for your naked picture. Or whatever it is, then you're going to start making money. That's the common knowledge out there. But look at on the screen, he said, how much can I make as an OnlyFans creator? On average, a novice, meaning someone who just signed up newly, a novice OnlyFans creator makes around $150 per month. $150 per month. But according to Etweb, top creators make on average, and these top creators, like he was, the lady mentioned, the top 1%, these are celebrities, which we're going to touch on next, make an average of $100,000 per month. So that's because they're already popular. So they can go in there and sell all kinds of content. And us, being dumb and stupid, these sisters just go into OnlyFans thinking they're going to start making $100,000 a month because that's what they heard. Because that's the common knowledge out there. $150 per month, what can that do for you? Is it worth it selling your body, showing your body for $150 per month? Even if it's $1 million per month, internet, like they say, internet is forever. Because if I'm not mistaken, I heard that in a podcast. Somebody said the thing that many of these women don't know is when you sign up to OnlyFans, they own the rights to your pictures and your video. You cannot sue them. So if somebody downloaded or OnlyFans, even if you leave OnlyFans and you keep using, or you leave OnlyFans and delete all your contents on OnlyFans, they have it. They can still sell it and make money off of it.
Yeah, one of the videos was saying they ripped the footage and posted on other porn sites. And the person that posted on that site, they make money off the content.
Right. Right. That's exactly what's going on. Internet is forever. All right? Internet is forever. You cannot delete your OnlyFans and think that's the end of it. No. Your job, they can even search you and find it. Your job can find you. Your friends can find you. Your parents can find you. Your spouse, if he or she, mostly in this situation is a he. If he does a diligent research, he might find something about you floating on the internet showing your nakedness, your vagina, your breasts to everybody. Excuse my French. All right, but we got to be real. We got to be real because we see lots of sisters in this podcast glorifying OnlyFans. Glorifying OnlyFans and following the ways of the heathen. Give me that. Proverbs 3, verse 31. Proverbs chapter 3, verse 31 just pop up in my head because that's exactly what I see in this podcast. Sometimes when I look into the shorts, some of these minute shorts or few second shorts, they don't want to listen to get away from online sex or cyber sex addiction, because that's what it is. Read.
The book of Proverbs, chapter 3 and verse 31. Mm-hmm. Envy thou not the oppressor.
Go on.
And choose none of his ways.
Choose none of his ways. All right? Choose none of his ways. You will see the majority of the people who first went in there were the Edomites. And the man that owned it is a British man. He's an Edomite. The Lord said what? Read one more time.
Envy thou not the oppressor.
Go on.
And choose none of his ways.
And choose none of his ways, all right? Don't choose any ways of these hidden, these hiddenish manners. We need to abstain from performing or participating in anything that they do, all right? Keep playing the video.
Not only that, but they're working the same amount of hours to try and gain the subscribers as they would working a full-time job. But the only difference is that a lot of them are doing that and barely making enough to survive. But the plot thickens, because the reason why you're not hearing about this is because OnlyFans works in a very particular way, whereby if you have an OnlyFans and you recruit someone to join the site and become a creator themselves, you could potentially earn money from what they're doing. Kind of sounds like a pyramid scheme.
So play that back. Take that back again. We all need to pay attention to this. Pay good attention, especially the women. Y'all young women who want that fast money and you think this is the way. Play that one more time.
Particular way, whereby if you have an OnlyFans and you recruit someone to join the site and become a creator themselves.
So if you got to recruit somebody, basically you are kind of like a pimp or a pimp assistant, if that exists. You OnlyFans make the creators pimps. That's what you are. You're recruiting people. You're assisting a pimp. The owner is already a pimp anyway. So you're assisting a pimp, recruiting more people into OnlyFans, and that's what you see on this podcast. That's why they go into this podcast, these women, our sisters, glorifying, especially in Miami. You have lots of them from Miami. You have a coven of OnlyFans creators, female OnlyFans creators in Miami. You have a lot of them from Miami. I want to say California. All right, that's what you see mostly on internet. Lord have mercy. So you got to recruit. If you want to make more money, you got to recruit more hoes. You got to recruit more people. That's wickedness. So you got to hate your people so bad to bring them into this devilish work. Because that's what it is. It's a devilish work. This evil site. Go on.
Potentially earn money from what they're doing. Kind of sounds like a pyramid scheme. And this is why so many OnlyFans girls say that they're earning so much money.
Pause it. Because they read what you have on the screen.
Referral program.
So referral program is the recruiting or recruitment program, I would say. The recruitment program that they were talking about, or this lady was talking about. Read.
The referral payout will be 5% of the referred creator's earnings for the first 12 months of their account.
First 12 months, go on.
Limited to the first $1 million earned by each referred creator. This allows referrers to earn up to $50,000 per referred creator.
Wow. So you can earn up to $50,000 as a referrer. You can earn up to $50,000 per anybody that you referred. You can earn up to that money. Because he said this allows referrers to earn up to $50,000 per referred creator. Lord have mercy. Go on.
There are no limitations on the number of referred creators or your total referral earnings.
See that? Now you're going to be so desperate. Because they do that on purpose. Because think about it. You sign up for OnlyFans and you earn only $150 in a month. Because you have the mindset that you're going to come in and start making money quickly. But then when you come in, it's not what you thought it was. Now you're going to be desperate to participate in a referral program. Now you have no option than to go and start bringing in more women or recruiting more women to sign up for OnlyFans so you can make lots of money. Because I remember seeing that in one of the podcasts, a lady came in with her OnlyFans manager. OnlyFans manager, agent. You can make this stuff up. This is a new way of prostitution on a higher level. But nobody has any problem with this. Government, they don't have any problem with this, but they have a problem with us posting videos about Christ being black. Most High God being black, the angels being black, the 12 tribe of Israel being the so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. They have problem with that. But not this. Not this evil. You got to be very desperate, man. Even if you're not, this alone will make you desperate. It will make you desperate, and you're going to have to start recruiting your own people. Kind of like you selling drugs to your own people. No difference.
So much money because they don't want to admit the truth to either themselves or other people. Because let's paint this scenario, right? Say, for example, you've started an account and suddenly it's dawned on you, after months of being a creator on this site, you're not making the millions that you were promised. And no matter how much work you put in and how much you're willing to go past what you initially planned to do, as in you start doing stuff.
Doing stuff. Because you're not making money like you thought you're going to make. Now you're going to have to, maybe you came in thinking you're going to just sell naked picture. And you're just earning, you don't have enough subscribers. Now guess what you're going to do as a woman or even men, I don't know. Shame on men who are doing this stuff. But now you get desperate. You came in with a mindset of selling naked pictures. Now you're going to have to start doing what? Stripping? You're going to have to start doing what? What else? Having live sex on the internet because you are desperate now to make money. Because you put all your effort to set your OnlyFans page up and it's not paying like you thought. Now you are stranded. Now you have to go the extra mile because you need that money. That millions, that six figures per month that you're hearing about, you want it so bad. Now you're going to have to be desperate. You're going to perform the acts, go beyond the limits. Lord have mercy.
Because like you're saying, Austin Emmanuel, they study our people and they know we got that covetous spirit. So they put these celebrities up here and they give off a certain type of persona or that they live a lifestyle. And then now OnlyFans come out, you know, common people of our people think they got a way to achieve to be like the City Girls or Sexy Red or Glorilla or whoever. Give me Sirach chapter 9, read verse 11.
The book of Sirach chapter 9 and verse 11. Envy not the glory of a sinner, for thou knowest not what shall be his end.
Right, so they exploit our people because they got a covetous spirit, because they envious of the people they see on TV, what they see on movies, what they see on social media. Read.
Delight not in the thing that the ungodly have pleasure in, but remember they shall not go unpunished unto their grave.
So they delight in the thing that the ungodly have pleasure in. So they out here and they done got themselves in a pyramid scheme. And like she was saying, you started off thinking, oh, I'm going to just take feet pictures, or I'm going to just show my hands, or I'm going to just pose in lingerie. But when 3 months go by and you only made $300, now you like, dang, I gotta get that $100,000 a year.
Right.
I mean, a month. So now I gotta recruit a brother to have sex with me live so I can get my followers up. But that wouldn't happen if our people knew God's laws and with not knowing God's laws, they allow themselves to be seduced into following people. And God told us to not envy our oppressors.
And you know what? Just to add to what you just said, and that's the reason why so many of these women who do OnlyFans, they like to go on these podcasts. You know, they have the what's this popular podcast that I've seen? Fresh and Fit. Fresh and Fit. They call it Fresh and Fit. Whatever podcast. Which other one? Damn, there are so many of them these days, man. But at least this Fresh and Fit is the most common one people go on to. They go on there to advertise themselves. All right, they'll give you the Instagram. They won't give you the OnlyFans. They'll give you the Instagram. Then when you go to the Instagram, the OnlyFans is attached to the Instagram. Yes, it's in your bio, exactly. Exactly, it's in the bio. And through that, through the Instagram, you get into the OnlyFans. So they actually go into these podcasts to advertise themselves. All right, so that they can make more money. Want to put themselves out there. And I'm not going to lie, this, it seems like it's happening for them with this podcast, especially the one we just mentioned, Fresh and Fit, whatever podcast. You know, sometimes they have good content. When I mean good, it's not that they don't read the scripture, but they say some stuff that are traditionally in the Bible. And majority of the time is foolery, all forms of garbage going on in them podcasts. All right, man, I had to get away from them podcasts. Back in, I want to say last year, very, very enticing. You'll be learning all kinds of garbage. They have all these transgenders and all these people coming in there, confusing the hell out of people, man. All right? But that's what they do. And some of them have OnlyFans. And you mess around thinking you're dealing with a woman on OnlyFans. And he said, dude, you're dealing with a dude. I don't want to even go in depth to that. Just keep playing the video, man.
Because let's paint this scenario, right? Say, for example, you've started an account and suddenly it's dawned on you, after months of being a creator on this site, you're not making the millions that you were promised. And no matter how much work you put in and how much you're willing to go past what you initially planned to do, as in, you start doing stuff that you're not really comfortable with because there's the potential to earn more money, you'd then reach a point where you'd think, okay, I've started down this path. Maybe a way that I could get out of it is if I get loads of other people onto the site so that I can earn from them, and maybe eventually I can get out of this. This is what I feel is happening to a lot of girls that are on this site.
That's then exactly what's going on. Give me the other video. Give me the other, hold on. Put the other video on the screen and let's get some scriptures. Give me 1 Timothy chapter 6. Yeah, 1 Timothy 6 verse 9.
The book of 1 Timothy chapter 6 and verse 9.
Mm-hmm.
But they that will be rich fall into temptation and a snare.
Read that one more time.
But they that will be rich.
And they that will be rich, not they are already rich. They that will, future, wants to be rich, go on.
Fall into temptation.
They fall into the temptation of going into OnlyFans or signing up for OnlyFans. Signing up for OnlyFans just because they've heard about making six figures or millions in a month. Fast lane collision. That's what awaits you. Fast lane collision. You're going to go in there fast and you're going to burn out quickly. Because that's prostitution. There's nothing righteous or virtuous about OnlyFans. Read it one more time.
But they that will be rich fall into temptation and a snare.
And a what?
And a snare.
And a snare. What is the snare? Hearing all these other women. Oh, yeah, I make six figures. Oh, you can leave whenever you want. When you get that money that you need for school or to buy a house for your mom or your dad, you can leave. No, you can leave, but your content is still owned by OnlyFans, and they can sell it. They can post it wherever they want, make more money, or somebody else can video you or, what they call it, rip the video and put it on their site and make money off of it. Internet is forever. Internet is forever, sisters. All right? Don't allow yourself to fall into that snare. Don't allow yourself, I repeat, do not allow yourself to fall into the snare of OnlyFans. No matter how broke you are. Because you will destroy yourself for life. And not just only you, your kids. Because that's the new thing now. People who do OnlyFans, they say they don't want to have kids. Because they know what they signed into. Or maybe they didn't know until they went in. They found out. They're like, I don't want to have kids. They want a husband, but they don't want kids. All right? We need to be very careful. We got to think 10 years ahead, 15 years ahead, Lord willing. All right? Think 10 steps ahead. How can this destroy you? Don't be selfish. Don't be self-centered. This can bring shame to your whole family. And even affect you from getting a good job too. Now, the only thing that you can do is add OnlyFans. Even if you leave, now you might have to go and do porn to survive. Or go and strip in the club. Or do all kinds of sexual immoral job to survive. Because you already soiled your name on internet. You gotta be careful. Read one more time from the top.
But they that will be rich fall into temptation and a snare.
Go on.
And into many foolish and hurtful lusts.
Into what?
Into many foolish and hurtful lusts.
Into many foolish and hurtful lusts. Hurtful lusts. Lusts that will hurt you. That will hurt you presently or in the future. Keep going.
Which drown men in destruction and perdition.
Which drown men, women, in what? Destruction and perdition. Destroy you. All right? Destroy you and put a bad legacy on you for the rest of your life. Even jobs that you sign up for or you apply for, they can research and they're going to find all those explicit contents of you. They're not going to hire you unless that's what the job is for and they didn't tell you on time. You might as well just go and maybe sign up for Hollywood. They can use you for porn scenes or naked or what they call sex scenes. Got to be careful out there. Read.
For the love of money.
For what?
For the love of money.
For what?
For the love of money.
For the love of money. Go on.
Is the root of all evil.
Is the root of all evil. Not money itself. Not money itself. He said the love. The love of money. Covetousness. Your covetous behavior or feeling towards money is what? The root of all forms of evil. All right? Y'all see what's going on with, what's his name? Right now, Diddy. That's exactly what's going on with him. What's the other guy? The Edomite. Epstein? Jeffrey Epstein? Harvey Weinstein? Root of all evil, love of money. T.D. Jakes, you see how all this stuff led to all kinds of sexual thoughts or lusts. All right? Because when you love money, when you get that money, guess what? You want to be in control because now you feel like you have power. You're on top of the world. Now you want to control people's life. And the majority of the time is sexual explicit or contents is involved. That's what goes on in the black community. That's what you see going on with Diddy. Read it one more time, verse 10.
For the love of money is the root of all evil.
Go on.
which while some coveted after.
Some coveted after, go on.
They have erred from the faith.
They have erred from where?
From the faith.
So this can happen to those who are in the body, who are already in the faith. Who are already in the faith. It will cause them to err and leave this truth. That's why we got to be careful. We got to make sure we apply these scriptures. Hold on. Give me that 1 Timothy chapter 4, verse 1.
The book of 1 Timothy chapter 4 and verse 1.
Uh-huh.
Now the Spirit speaketh expressly.
That the scripture, the Spirit speaketh with boldness, with assurance. Go on.
That in the latter times.
In these last days.
Some shall depart from the faith.
Some shall do what?
Depart from the faith.
Go on.
Giving heed to seducing spirits.
Giving heed to what?
Seducing spirits.
Seducing spirits. Seducing spirits telling you you can make six figures in a month. You can make a million in a month. All you got to do is you can sell a picture of yourself. Sell a picture. Just show your foot, your feet. That's all you got to do. And you get enticed and your spirit of covetousness starts brewing within you. And before you know it, you give in to the temptation. Now you sign up and get stuck on stupid for the rest of your life. Read it one more time, 1 Timothy.
1 Timothy chapter 4 and verse 1.
Uh-huh.
Now the Spirit speaketh expressly.
Go on.
That in the latter times some shall depart from the faith.
Many of us are going to leave these truths. Go on.
Giving heed to seducing spirits.
Because you are giving heed to seducing spirits, telling you you can make six figures. OnlyFans can solve your problem like this. Go on.
And doctrines of devils.
Doctrines of deceivers. Doctrines of deceivers. That's what we just heard this lady say. That's exactly what this lady said when he said people go in thinking they're going to make money because that's what they heard. And then that's not the case. Go back to 1 Timothy chapter 6. Start from verse 10 again.
1 Timothy chapter 6 and verse 10.
Mm-hmm.
For the love of money is the root of all evil.
Go on.
Which while some coveted after, they have erred from the faith.
They have erred from the faith. Depart from the faith. From the faith. It didn't say err in the faith. It said erred from the faith. It will make you, it can make you depart from the faith. That's if you don't know the reason why you are in this truth. If you're in this truth thinking you're going to be a millionaire or be rich, that's not the purpose of this truth. The purpose of this truth is to build our wealth in the kingdom to come, not in this world where it can be taken away from you easily. No. Go on.
And pierce themselves through with many sorrows.
They pierce themselves through with many sorrows because they got desperate. They got to do everything possible to make this money. All right? Now they got to start recruiting people. Now they're going to go from selling pictures to showing their naked body all over the internet for subscription, pay-per-view, or tips. Now you are, how do you say here? Piercing yourself through with many sorrows just so you can get to the level of six figures because that's what your friends told you that they're making. You don't even know if it's true. You don't even know if it's true. You just look at what they put on or what they hear. They might, shoot, some of these women might be traveling to Middle East to see the rich men. They might be traveling to, Dubai, United Arab Emirates, to go have freak off, whatever it is, with some of these sheikh sons or children. They allow themselves to peed on, doodled on, to go make money and come back. And believe me, all of them have OnlyFans. They won't tell you that's how they make their money. They will tell you that's how they make their money. All right? That's what ends up happening. Escort or sex work. Go on. Verse 11.
But thou, O man of God.
You, O man of God.
Flee these things.
You sisters, flee from these doctrine of devils, seducing spirits. All right? Love of money, OnlyFans, flee, run away from it. It's full of evil. It's full of evil. Read one more time.
But thou, O man of God,
who is in this faith,
flee these things.
Flee these things. Go on.
And follow after righteousness.
Follow after the laws of God. You all know what righteousness is. Romans 6 verse 25. Follow after the laws and commandments of God. You got to chase after it. That's the reason why Solomon spoke about going after wisdom like a woman. The way you love to chase a woman or you like to chase men, that's how you should chase wisdom of God. Chase these laws, this righteousness of God. You got to go after it with everything you have. Go on.
And follow after righteousness.
Go on.
Godliness, faith, love, patience, meekness.
These are the fruits of the Spirit. These are the fruits of the Spirit. Go on.
Fight the good fight of faith.
Fight the good fight of faith. The good fight of faith. Fight to stay in this truth, to overcome your temptation. Apply the laws of God. Pray. Study. Pray and apply. Fast. Seek counsel so you can overcome the trials and tribulations that's before you. Because all of us must go through it. 2 Ezra chapter 7 told you that. All of us must go through it to get into the kingdom. All right? Keep going.
Lay hold on eternal life, whereunto thou art also called.
Go on.
And hast professed a good profession.
A good what?
A good profession.
This truth is our profession. Teaching this truth. Raising up the 12 tribe of Israel, this is our career. It's not a part-time job. This is your main career. You are not going to be judged by Christ on being a doctor, being a judge, being audited. Of course, if you do evil in those things, you're going to be judged for it. But obtaining the certificate or the license is not what's going to get you into the kingdom. The Lord is not going to judge you based on how many certificates you have or license you have. The Lord will judge you based on what did you do to raise up the 12 tribe of Israel. What did you do to serve Israel in a better way or in good ways according to the law? That's what the Lord will judge you on. That's why these truths, whether you be a man who go to camp, you do fly mission, you go to the Blitz, you do all the stuff, do international travels, you have to keep doing that. Remain persistent, all right? Because that's our profession. That's our career. All right, keep going.
And has professed a good profession before many witnesses.
Before what?
Before many witnesses.
Before many witnesses, all right? Because our people, they see us. Not just our people in this truth, our people outside. There are so many of them watching us. They may not be here now, but they are watching. And they are supporting from behind the shadows, all right? From the shadows or behind closed doors, they are supporting this truth. All right, let's not take it for granted what we're doing. Give me Sirach 31. Sirach chapter 31, verse 5. 31, verse 5. You're going to read through to verse 9, all right?
The book of Sirach, chapter 31 and verse 5.
Uh-huh.
He that loveth gold shall not be justified.
Read it one more time.
He that loveth gold shall not be justified.
He that loveth money shall not be justified. If you love money, you cannot be justified in Christ. All right, go on.
And he that followeth corruption mm-hmm. shall have enough thereof.
Because that's what's going to come. To gain these riches in this world, you got to defile yourself. You got to walk on the Sabbath day, break Sabbath laws, high holy feast days, because Esau is not going to give you 100,000 not make you break the laws of God or make you walk on the Sabbath day. It's not possible unless the Lord have a special favor towards you. But in majority of the cases, Esau will not give you $100,000, $200,000 per year, $300,000 or above, and you're just going to walk Monday to Friday how you want. No. They will call you in on weekends. They will make you work on weekends. All right, they will do all kinds of stuff that you will see will make you break the laws of God. There is no way you want to make money in this present life. As a black man or black woman, you are not going to do evil. You are not going to corrupt your soul. It doesn't matter what you think. That's why he said, read that part again.
He that loveth gold shall not be justified. Mm-hmm. And he that followeth corruption.
He that do what?
Followeth corruption.
You got to follow corruption to make that money. If you love money so much, you got to follow corruption. That's why you see what happening to the musicians. Our brothers who are in the music industry, the sisters, in Hollywood, in sports. Sports, you got to do what? They're not going to sign all that millions on your head. And you're just going to do sports. When it's time for you to perform, you're going to be like, I'm an Israelite. I keep the Sabbath. I cannot throw basketball on Sabbath day. I cannot do MMA, box, play NFL, play soccer on Sabbath day. That's why they put it all on Sabbath. It's a snare for the children of Israel. Why can't they do it any other day? Why does it have to be on Sabbath day? That's the thing we don't understand. We are at war. This is war, brothers and sisters. They want you to corrupt yourself. If you want that money, you want to make that six figures, you got to corrupt yourself. Because Satan is the one giving you that money. The so-called white man is the one giving you that money. So you must do the deed of your father, the devil, or I would say of his father, the devil, for you to get that riches. All right? We got to learn from Christ in Matthew 4. We got to learn from Christ himself. Read.
Gold hath been the ruin of many, and their destruction was present.
See that? Gold had been the ruin of what?
Of many.
Money. Riches has been the ruin of many Israelites. Go on.
And their destruction was present.
And their destruction was what?
Was present.
That's what you see going on right now with your brother Didi. Destruction is present. And, you know, some of our people don't think this kind of stuff true. Probably it is a very good thing that is happening now in this present life. You don't want that second death. This destruction, this humiliation, everything you're going through now, probably somebody who's wise will see it as a way of being like, you know what? Damn, I'm going to fix myself. I'm going to fix myself. I've done people wrong. I've stolen from people. I've made money from people. All right? God is giving me an opportunity. You could have been killed. How are you going to get away from that? How will you get away from that if you are murdered doing all this kind of evil? All right, give me that. Something just popped in my mind. Luke chapter 19 about Zacchaeus.
The book of Luke chapter 19 and verse 1.
Uh-huh.
And Jesus entered and passed through Jericho. And behold, there was a man named Zacchaeus, which was the chief among the publicans. And he was rich.
So Zacchaeus is a chief among the publicans. And if you know historically during those days, our people hate publicans. Or the tax collectors. They make lots of money off of the people. They are extorting people, taking usury from the people. And Zacchaeus was one of them. That's what the scripture said. And he was rich. All right, he was rich. Go on.
And he sought to see Jesus, who he was, and could not for the press, because he was little of stature.
Because there were so many people around Christ, and he was short. He couldn't see Christ. Go on.
And he ran before and climbed up into a sycamore tree to see him, for he was to pass that way.
Go on.
And when Jesus came to the place, he looked up and saw him and said unto him, Zacchaeus, make haste and come down, for today I must abide at thy house.
So Christ said, today I will abide in your house. All right, go on.
And he made haste and came down and received him joyfully.
Received Christ joyfully. Go on.
And when they saw it, they all murmured, saying that he was gone to be guest with a man that is a sinner.
That's our people. All right? The people around Christ was murmuring because they know who Zacchaeus was. He was extorting the people, making money off the people. All right, go on.
And Zacchaeus stood and said unto the Lord, behold, Lord, the half of my goods I give to the poor.
Go on.
And if I have taken anything from any man by false accusation.
By what?
By false accusation.
If I have taken money from the people through false accusation, falsely made money off your fellow Israelites. All right, go on.
I restore him fourfold.
What did scripture say?
I restore him fourfold.
That's what Zacchaeus did. That's the spirit that he had. You have so many of these music producers who were stealing from black artists like Diddy with Bad Boy. Go back to Sirach 31. Read out verse 6 again.
The book of Sirach, chapter 31 and verse 6. Mm-hmm. Gold hath been the ruin of many.
Go on.
And their destruction was present.
And their destruction was present, awaiting them. All right? Your destruction is already there, programmed for you. But we have to be like Zacchaeus. Especially all these our brothers involved in OnlyFans, and you are pimping the sisters, acting, they're calling themselves managers. That's the new name, not pimp anymore. I'm a manager. I'm her agent. Making money off of your sister involved in prostitution. All right? You got to be like Zacchaeus. Stop taking money from the people. Stop OnlyFans or OnlyPawn, whatever you call it. OnlyFans, OnlyPawn. Only fornication, only fornication. Stop. Repent before your destruction comes. All right? That's what people like Diddy should do. Give back the money to those you stole it from. Nobody, man, you go on internet, nobody who was an old artist or Bad Boy like him. Nobody like him, even the security. The bodyguards, nobody has anything good to say about this dude. And he got some people looking at him at the picture from TMZ in the Miami airport last week saying they feel bad for him. He looks so lonely. Of course, he got to be lonely because he was dealing bad with the people that was around him. He dealt so evil with the people. He dealt so bad and wrong to the people. So why the hell would you feel bad for him? If he's wise, he should repent. Now that he's still alive, he still have the chance to repent. But I digress, all right? Keep reading what you have, Sirach 31.
Verse 7, mm-hmm. It is a stumbling block unto them that sacrifice unto it.
See that? Money. Money is a stumbling block unto those who do what?
That sacrifice unto it.
They sacrifice their time, the time they could have used. You know you do 8 to 5 or 9 to 5 job and the money is enough. But you choose to take overtime so that you can stay and make extra money that you, if you're being honest, you don't need. The 8 to 5 was enough to pay your bills, take care of your family, but you want to choose overtime that you could have used to go and do a fly mission, do camp. You chose that time to do an overtime because you're greedy, you're covetous. Sabbath day, you know you have option of taking Sabbath day off, but you're not going to say anything to your boss. And then you're going to come to leadership and be like, yeah, my boss, they don't let me off on Sabbath day. Because your job is open on Sabbath day doesn't mean that you should be there on Sabbath day. Have you spoken to your boss first to see if they can give you a relief on Sabbath days? No, because you want that money, that extra money so bad. Read that part again. Read it again. Verse 7,
it is a stumbling block unto them that sacrifice unto it.
You have to now you are sacrificing your Sabbath day for it. You are sacrificing the Lord's work for it. Because you love that money so damn much. Read.
And every fool.
And every what?
And every fool.
Every unwise man, unwise woman, go on.
Shall be taken therewith.
They shall be taken therewith. And you know what? Some of our sisters who have a normal job, they don't see the money enough. Now they want to have a side hustle. And guess what a side hustle can be? OnlyFans. OnlyFans. They set up an OnlyFans because the money they make is not enough for them. They want to make sure they have enough to buy a Birkin bag or Gucci or red bottoms. They need the extra money. But they got to be a whore to get it. All right, keep going.
Blessed is the rich that is found without blemish.
See that? Blessed is he who has money, but without doing evil to get it, corrupting themselves to get it, sacrificing the time they should give to the Lord to get it. Go on.
And have not gone after gold.
But they are not chasing after gold. They are not chasing after money or riches. Go on.
Who is he?
Who is that person who made his living without corrupting their soul? Go on.
And we will call him blessed.
And we will call you blessed. Go on.
For wonderful things has he done among his people.
Wonderful thing. Because now you're a good example among the people. When you read 42, it talks about giving alms to the people, helping the people who have need, all right? Play the next video.
Who's the most, the biggest earner on OnlyFans?
I don't know. That's
Black
a good...
China.
Black
China.
What? $20 million.
That's Joe Rogan. This guy is a damn racist. Yeah, I mean, I don't know why he did what he did. It's funny what he did. It's actually funny because he act like he about to throw up. Black China doesn't have good reputation. He has a slut, or should I say a whole reputation. All right? Being around, what's his name? Tiger. Slept around with Tiger, had a baby. She used to be a stripper. Slept around with China. That's how people came to know her. Being with Tiger, had a baby with Tiger. Jumped from Tiger to, what's his name? The Edomite. Rob Kardashian. Kim Kardashian's brother. Had a baby for him. That's a hoe. But she can repent. That's one thing she has other nations don't have. As an Israelite woman, she can repent before the time is late.
What is a nation? Nation is family. Nation is community. Nation is men leading by example. Nation is women's support. Nation is children with role models. Nation is unity. Nation is you.